This is a short film about the complexities of setting Cinerama up for one show. First of all, we have to open the curtains and masking that surround the flat screen. The flat screen is used for standard film presentations. The screen is then raised into the roof. Along with its five speakers, this takes approximately 2.5 minutes. We speeded it up here a little bit just to save time. This now reveals the Cinerama curtains and screen. The screen is made up of more than 1,200 louvers, vertically positioned in guides to face the audience. This is so that the light from either side projector reflects back out to the audience and not across to the other side of the screen, which would then wash the picture out. The screen has to be checked before each show because the odd louver tends to pop out of its guides. This can be quite time consuming, especially if there's more than one out, and even more so if it's at the top of the screen, because then we need ladders to get up there. The amplifiers that feed the speakers behind the flat screen, which are now up in the ceiling of the stage area, have to be disconnected and patched over to feed the speakers behind the Cinerama screen. The prologue, which precedes This Is Cinerama, is laced up on our standard Victoria 8 projector. It is standard 35mm film with 4 perforations per frame pull down and an optical mono soundtrack. Now the Cinerama projectors have to be got ready. There are 3 projectors and they have names: Abel, Baker, Charlie. Abel shows to the left hand side of the screen, Charlie to the right, and Baker in the centre. Now the 3 projectors have to be synchronised together. This is done by turning the inching knob on the motor until the intermittent sprocket has just stopped moving. The 2 red dots on the motor and inching knob come together and the shutter is just across the top of the aperture. This is a time-consuming exercise which can take up to 50 turns of the inching knob before those 3 things all come together. And this same exercise has now to be performed on the other 2 projectors. The sound reproducing machine has got to be put in sync with the 3 projectors. Again, this is done by lining up 2 red dots on the motor and inching knob. Now we can lock all 4 machines together. If anything moves at this point, something is out of sync. Now I can lace the 3 films into the 3 projectors. The first one to be laced up is Baker, which is the centre projector. The film, which comes from the plate machine at the far end of the projection room, has to travel over many rollers on the front wall to get past our DP70 Todio projector and our Victoria 8 standard projector to get to the Cinerama machine. Now I've got there, I can put the film in the projector. What I'm doing now is pulling the film down until I find the start mark. There it is. This has to be positioned exactly in the aperture behind the lens. Now I've laced the film up, it has to travel all the way along the front wall again, back to the plate machine. The two side projectors run from towers, and they have to be laced up just the same with the start mark in the apertures. There are 7 channels of sound, 5 behind the screen, and a left and a right surround. These are recorded on a 35mm fully coated magnetic tape. The sound tape, like the film, has a start mark on it. This has to be positioned exactly on the sound head, as you can see me doing here. To get to this point can take a full hour or more. But now we're ready to start the show. The push of one button starts all 3 projectors and the sound machine together. As you can see, the Cinerama frame is 6 sprocket holes high, as opposed to the standard 4. This gives us extra height needed for Cinerama. And when the 3 frames come together, it gives us the widest angle of any cinema format, 146 degrees. This gives you the feeling of being in the picture. And when it's projected on a deeply curved screen in Pictureville Cinema, ladies and gentlemen, this is Cinerama.